Hi, and welcome to Hacking ABA. My name is JP Filippello, a clinical associate with Brett Denovi & Associates. Today's video will review the importance of ABA practitioners collaborating with school staff. I think it's safe to say that collaboration is considered best practice in the field of applied behavior analysis and generally results in desirable client outcomes. But did you know that a study conducted in 2013 reported that while ABA practitioners frequently collaborate with a variety of professionals and view collaboration as important, on average, those same practitioners receive little to no formal training in collaboration? The authors of the study I'm referring to are Amy Kelly and Matt Tincani, who published the article Collaborative Training and Practice Among Applied Behavior Analysis, who support individuals with autism spectrum disorder. Kelly and Tincani conducted a study on collaborative training and practice among 302 applied behavior analysts in 2013. Results of their study concluded that 67% of those who participated in the study reported no coursework with collaboration in the title, and 45% reporting attending workshops with no collaboration in the title. This definitely highlights the needs to support collaboration as a skill set. ABA practitioners play an integral role as interdisciplinary team members to develop instructional programs for students. This means helping general and special education teachers, related services, providers, and administrators to embed behavioral teaching techniques with inclusive settings. Although Kelly and Tincani state in the article that there is no standard operational definition for collaboration, collaboration is noted as a common characteristic of a variety of consultation methods that results in a learner's progress. It is clear that future research should examine the most effective ways to teach collaboration skills and to explore modes of collaboration beyond face-to-face interaction formats. But how can we make this happen? Matthew Broadhead suggests in his article, Maintaining Professional Relationships in an Interdisciplinary Setting, that behavior clinicians and related service providers work closely together. He says that these collaborations could actually improve educational outcomes and increase treatment fidelity. More specific collaborative practices, Broadhead mentions, include working as a team to address client goals and understanding the individual strengths each professional brings to the interdisciplinary team. Why? Because doing so will allow learners who attend a collaborative interdisciplinary setting to have the opportunity to receive well-rounded services that best meet the individual's needs. Thanks for watching. If you like what you learned, subscribe for more.